Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy English with Mono. Manoj Mathew here, and today in this video we are going to learn one of the very important and basic part of English grammar. So you all know that English grammar is very very important, and it is called the backbone of any language. It can be either any languages, whether it can be Urdu, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, or whatever the language, it can be around the globe. The main and major role plays by grammar. So you all know that there are many many parts of grammar that we call parts of speech, direct indirect speech, active passive voice, so on so on so on. So if you are very sound and excellent at grammar, then you can speak English better, and of course you can write English better. So here in this video I would like to teach you the basic of English grammar, that's all about active and passive voice. I think you have already learned what active voice is and what passive voice is. Okay, so you may just take out your notebook and write down whatever I write on this whiteboard. So it will be more easy for you to attend the class live and at the same time to take notes, that whatever I am going to give you here on this whiteboard. Okay? So you can just take out the notebook and write down what we are going to learn today is active and passive. So first of all, let's make the point very clear that what active and passive voice is. So when we think about active voice, when we talk about active voice, there the importance is always given to subject. What is subject? And the subject means the person. The person or doer of an action. So here I am just giving you the timeline that it will be easy for you to understand. Okay. Active voice means, just simply understand that, you know, to do any work there must be a person, yeah? In order to happen any action there must be a person. So the person is getting more important. So suppose that if you want to talk about that, suppose that I am doing something. What I am doing here, I am lecturing, I am writing, I am explaining, and I am speaking. Okay, so here who is getting more important? I means the person. What I am talking about is the subject, that means person. So in a sentence, listen very carefully, in a sentence, if the person, that means the doer of an action, is getting more important, then that type of sentence is called active voice. And you already know a person is always active, right? A person is more active. So in order to that, the subject, that means the person, in a sentence, if it is getting more active, more important, then that is called active voice. So one example we can see, here you can just see one example like, I play chess. I play chess. Here, what is the first word? That is subject, I, because the importance is given to the person, I. I is the subject. So this is done by a person. Means the doer of action is I. So this sentence is called active voice. And here the active voice, in the active voice there is subject I. What is the subject here in this sentence? I is subject, and play is the verb, and what I play, that is called object. So after the play there is an object. Okay? So chess is object. Okay? So it is a very very basic and fundamental understanding about the active voice. Means the person is getting more importance, means the person is the doer of action, or the person is doing any action. Okay? So now I'm just going to explain to you what is passive voice is in simple way, and then after we will talk about and see many examples of active and passive voice. So you can just look at the board and write down whatever you understood in your own words. So now let's come to understand what Basi voice is. Basi voice means an action is carried to or done by someone. Okay, so this is the importance of passive voice. So in the passive voice, what we call an action is carried to. We do not know who has done. The importance is given to the verb. Importance is given to action. So this is some of the very basic understanding. Try to understand. In passive voice, the importance is not given to subject. Importance is given to the action or object. Normally the importance is given to object. Okay? So we will come to know in that active voice what sentence I have already given you, that we can change to passive voice. Okay? So always the importance is given to action or object. Okay? So let's see the example that I have given. I play chess. So this is active voice because the importance is given to subject. Okay? I play chess. So now listen very carefully to understand the rule of how passive voice works. So in this sentence, subject is I and the verb is play, and then after, what is the object here after play? Chess. So subject is I, play is verb, and chess is object. Clear? So now what did I explain to you? In the passive voice, what is getting more important? Chess. That means object. So here, this chess has to come at its subject place. The object in any sentence that gets importance, then that is passive. So we have to give more importance to the object. So in this sentence, chess is object. So we have to change that into passive voice, giving importance to this object, chess. Clear? So let's change. The object that I have taken to its subject place, chess. Okay. Now the second part to understand very carefully is we have to use the grammar according to the tense. In this sentence, I play chess, the tense is used simple present tense. What is the tense? Simple present tense. So in simple present tense, when we change that active voice into passive voice, we have to add either is or am or are, then after V3 form. That means past participle form of the verb we have to form. Okay. So in that case, I play chess is simple present tense. Yeah. So chess is in its subject place because this is the last word, object. That's why we have taken. Okay. And since it is simple present, we have to use what is the helping verb we have to use? Either is, am, or are. So chess after it followed by is, because it's singular, right? Chess is. Then after, what is the verb? Play. So we have to follow the past participle. That means the third form of the verb you have to use in passive voice. So what is the third form of the verb play? Played. Chess is played. After verb, we have to use a preposition, that is by. Who is? The action is carried. The action is carried by somebody else, right? Or the object that is done by somebody else. So here in this case, we have to use the preposition by. Very simple, yeah. So chess is played by. I change into me. Yes, you already know it. I change into me. So chess is played by me. Okay, so this is a very, very basic understanding of active voice and passive voice. Okay, so hope it is clear to you. You can just write down this in your notebook. I play chess. It is an active voice because the importance is given to the person, because the person is doing some work. I, the subject. But when we talk about the object in its important place, then we change that play, chess object into subject place, and we give importance to that object, and that will be in passive voice. So that sentence will be changed to chess is played by me. Okay, so I hope you understood some very basic understanding about this active and passive voice. Okay. So now I'm going to give you all tense forms, how it changes from active voice to passive voice. So before that, you can just write down whatever you can see on this whiteboard, and take write in your notebook very carefully, and make your personal notes well and good. Okay, so my dear students, now I'm going to give you how each tense changes in active to passive. So we are going to talk about examples of tenses. Okay, we are getting multiple learning. Okay, so you will get to know different form of tenses, and at the same time, how each tense can be changed from active to passive voice. So it's a kind of multitasking for you in this special video lesson. So hope you are going to enjoy it, and you are going to definitely learn much more better. Okay? So we will see one by one sentences, one by one examples in tense that how can be changed to passive voice. Okay? So the first one that I have given is simple present. Okay? In simple present, let's take one example. The verb eat or eat. Why did I take the verb? Because the verb defines the tense of the sentence. The verb defines the time of any sentence. That's why I'm taking only one example of the verb eat in different tenses. So hope it's clear to you. So the only one verb that I'm going to make it in different tenses, and you will come to know how that verb can be changed in passive voice. So if you know one verb, how it changes, then you will come to know how can you change all other tenses, right? So the verb is eat or eat. Eat or eat, it is in simple present, right? I eat, we eat. I eat ice cream, we eat watermelon. She eats ice cream, he eats biryani, okay, whatever it can be. So eat or eat is a basic form of verb, and it is in simple present tense. So the point is how this changes to passive voice. Here you have to pay full attention on this rule, but I am going to explain here. Okay? Eat and eats in simple present, and how it is changed? Either is eaten. Is eaten. If it is singular, then it is eaten. I eat chocolate. I eat chocolate. I eat chocolate. Chocolate is eaten. Do you understand? I eat chocolate. Chocolate is eaten. But when comes are, not only is used, there will be plural also. Example, I eat chocolate. Chocolate, plural. The object is plural. I eat chocolate. So how can we change into passive voice? Chocolates are eaten. Do you understand? I eat chocolate. Chocolates are eaten. So in that case, there you have to use are eaten. Hope you are getting the point. Yeah? So this is the fundamental of grammar, active and passive voice, about the first tense, simple present. Yes. Now let's come to the second one, present continuous, means present progressive, an action that is going on. In that case, the active voice will be is eating or are eating, right? Am I right? In present progressive, in present continuous tense, the form of the active voice is eating or are eating. One example, he is eating, we are eating, and if I want to talk about myself, I am eating. I am eating. Okay. So the part is very, very clear to you, right? He or she. He is eating a chocolate. She is eating a chocolate. We are eating chocolate. They are eating chocolate. You are eating mango. I am eating chocolate. I am eating watermelon. I am eating mango. So this is the present progressive. That means present continuous tense. Okay? So in this case, how can we change into passive voice? Do you understand? The sentence is very clear to you, right? He is eating a chocolate. The sentence is in present continuous and it is in active voice. He is eating a chocolate. Okay? So in that sentence, a chocolate is object. So you have to give importance to the object, a chocolate. So a chocolate is being eaten. So the passive voice of this particular present continuous tense is that you can see here, okay, is being eaten. Okay, so what is the difference? Did you find any difference in this sentence? Is eating, is being eaten, is being, this word is extra here, B-E-I-N-G. It works only with present continuous into passive voice, okay? So is being, and the third form of the verb, what is the third form of the verb? Eat, eaten, eaten, okay? So this is clear. So is being eaten, and in this case what will be? We are eating a mango. That depends upon the object. If the object is singular, then it will be is, and if the object is plural, then it will be are. One example I am trying to make you understand, just listen very carefully and write down in your notebook, okay? So your personal note will be more useful for you to refer in future, so that this is a kind of best practice that you attend this special video lecture to learn the basic grammar in its best form, because you have this with you in the form of recorded place. An example I'm going to make you clearly. Why is used? Because the object is singular. And if you want to use are, then that object has to be plural. One example, you write down in your notebook, she is eating a chocolate. She is eating a chocolate. Write down, she is eating a chocolate. Okay, so did you understand what is subject verb object? She is subject, is eating verb, an object, a chocolate. What is the verb? What is the object? A chocolate. A chocolate is the object. Okay, so in that sentence, how can we change into passive voice? Yeah, a chocolate is being eaten. A chocolate is being eaten. Okay, because a chocolate, that is singular. A chocolate is singular. That's why we use is. A chocolate is being eaten. Okay, write down in your notebook the passive voice. A chocolate is being eaten by her. A chocolate is being eaten by her. Okay, so let's come to the next sentence. There you will come to know how are is to be used. The same sentence I'm going to give you. He is eating chocolate. You may write down in your notebook. He is eating chocolate. He is eating chocolate. Okay. In that sentence, you know, it is already in active voice, in present continuous tense. He, subject, is eating, verb, chocolate, object. So, did you understand what is object? Chocolate. So, if it's singular or plural? Yeah, it's plural. So, what did I say? If the object, when it comes to its subject place, according to that, we have to use the helping verb. So, chocolate, that is plural. So, we have to use in passive voice like, chocolates are being eaten. What is the passive voice of that sentence? Chocolates are being eaten. You may write down in your notebook. Chocolates are being eaten by him. Chocolates are being eaten by him. So this is some of the very basic fundamental of this present continuous tense in active voice and passive voice. So hope it is very, very clear to you. Okay? And the next sentence here it is, I am eating a chocolate. That is also same, because the object, according to the object, you have to use is or are, right? I am eating a chocolate. A chocolate is being eaten by me. I am eating chocolate. Chocolates are being eaten by me. Okay. So this is all about present continuous tense. Now let's come to the next tense. What may be the second tense? First one is simple present, then present continuous. The next one that I'm going to give you one sentence, one example. You have to identify and you have to comment below what the tense I am going to write here. So according to your idea, you may let me know in the comment box what is the tense that I am writing here in the active voice. Has eaten have eaten. Do you know what is the tense of this structure? Yes, present perfect tense. It's in present perfect tense. Has eaten or have eaten. Okay, so we are going to see one example and we'll learn how to change it into passive voice. Okay. She has eaten a chocolate. It's in active voice, present perfect. She has eaten a chocolate. You may write down the example in your notebook. She has eaten a chocolate. Or he has eaten a chocolate. Okay. In the sentence, you know, the subject is he and the verb is has eaten. And the object is a chocolate. So in that sentence, he has eaten a chocolate. We have to change it into passive voice by adding some extra words like has eaten will be changed in passive voice like has or have been eaten. Hope it's clear to you, right? Has or have, then the word, what is this? Been, B-E-E-N, been eaten. So this is the structure of passive voice in present perfect tense. Has or have means has goes with singular, have goes with plural, and also with subject singular person, first person, I have. Okay. So let's see both active and passive voice of this tense, present perfect. He has eaten a chocolate. That will be changed into a chocolate has been eaten by him. A chocolate has been eaten by him. You may write down in your notebook. a chocolate has been eaten by him. Okay, so when do we use have? Yeah, if it is plural. He has eaten chocolate. He has eaten chocolate. Chocolate, plural. So that will be into passive like. Chocolate have been, have. H-A-V-E, have. Chocolate have been eaten by him. Chocolate have been eaten by him. Okay, so my dear students, you may just write down the examples in your notebook and keep it in record with you. This is for your future reference. Yeah. So three tense forms in present that we have discussed: present simple, present continuous, present perfect. And the fourth one that is in present is present perfect continuous, that is not normally changed to passive voice. Present perfect continuous is not normally changed to passive voice. Okay, so I hope it is very, very clear to all of you. Now we are going to learn active and passive voice in past tense. How past tense works with active and especially with passive voice. So you may just get ready to take notes that I will be writing here about all past tense forms in active and passive voice. The first part of past is simple past. So simple past, you know, the verb eat will be changed into ate. A-T-E. It is the second form of the verb eat. Ate, eaten. So second form of the verb, the second form of the verb is simple past. So ate is used here, ate. And how it is changed in passive voice that we are going to see. Let's see one example. I ate a chocolate. I ate a chocolate. In simple past, it would be was eaten or were eaten. I ate a chocolate. I ate a chocolate. You just write down in your notebook example. I ate, simple past, okay? In simple past, I ate a chocolate. In passive voice, a chocolate was eaten by me. A chocolate was eaten. I ate chocolate. Chocolates were eaten by me. Chocolates were eaten by me. So this is the sentence that is normally in simple past. Okay. So let's see one example more. You may write down in your book. I ate a burger. Write down, please. I ate a burger. Burger. I ate a burger. So in that sentence, I subject ate verb. And object is a burger. A burger. I ate a burger. Okay. That in passive voice, how it would be? A burger was eaten by me. A burger was eaten by me. Okay. So now I just want you to comment below one example in active and passive voice using simple past tense. So everybody has to comment below one example of simple past in both active and passive voice. And those who make correct sentence, then I will definitely give a heart from my side and also, of course, a like. So let's come to the next part of past. Past continuous. What is the past continuous form of eat? Was eating or were eating? Past continuous. Was eating. Normally goes with I. I was eating a chocolate. I was. Was. I was eating a chocolate. We were eating a chocolate. We were, I hope it's clear to you, were. We were eating. I was eating and we were eating. It's okay. So how it would be changed in passive voice?
Was or were.
I use here was or were. That is because was goes with singular and were goes with plural. That's why. Okay. So either was or were has to be used. Then after
being eaten.
Was eating. I was eating a chocolate. Hope the sentence is clear to you. I was eating a chocolate. A chocolate was being eaten. Among these two, only one has to be used. Okay? You have to choose either was or were according to the subject. Okay? So I was it. You may just write down the sentence in notebook. I was eating a chocolate. I was eating a chocolate. And in passive voice, a chocolate was being eaten by me. A chocolate was being eaten by me. Okay, so hope it is clear to you. A chocolate was being eaten. Yeah. So now come to another sentence that is used with where. We were eating mangoes. We were eating mangoes. So the subject, you may just write down this example in your notebook. We were eating mangoes. So you may just write down that sentence in your notebook. And what is the subject, verb, object in that sentence? We were eating mangoes. Yeah, subject is we and verb were eating and object mangoes. What is object? Mangoes. So is it plural or singular? It's plural. More number of mangoes. So plural. So in that case, we have to be very careful to use were. So how can we change that into passive voice? Yeah. Mangoes were being eaten by us. We change into us. Okay. Mangoes were being eaten by us. You may just write down the example in your notebook. Mangoes were being eaten by us. Okay, so this is all about past continuous tense in both active and passive. So my dear friends, hope it's very, very clear to all of you. Okay, so now let's come to what may be the next part of the past, simple past continuous and past perfect. Here it is.
The structure of past perfect is had eaten.
The verb eaten, had eaten. Past perfect structure is had eaten. Had eaten. Okay. One example I can say, I had eaten pulao, I had eaten manchurian, I had eaten noodles. So the structure in past perfect, had eaten. Okay. So how can we change that into passive voice? One example that I had eaten a mango. A mango had been eaten. In passive voice it would be had, then after been, then after the third form of the verb. So hope it's clear to you. Had been eaten. E-A-E-A-T-E-N. Eaten. Had been eaten. Had eaten. Had been eaten. Okay. One example you may just write down in your notebook. Okay. More than that, what I have given here. One example I would like to give you. You may just write down in notebook. She had eaten a watermelon. She had eaten a very big watermelon. She had eaten a watermelon. Okay. Whatever the sentence you can write. You can just write down. She had eaten a watermelon. She had eaten a watermelon. Okay. So how can we change into passive voice? a watermelon had been eaten by her. Write down the example in your notebook. A watermelon had been eaten by her. A watermelon had been eaten by her. Okay, so this is the past perfect. So one, I request you to write one more example in active and passive voice using past perfect. I mean, just write down the example in your notebook. One or two examples you can write down, so it will be more useful for you to just test yourself whether you understood the fact and concept, whether it is clear or not. Yeah. So we have almost discussed all the parts of past tense, simple past, past continuous and past perfect. One thing is remaining, past perfect continuous. Past perfect continuous is not commonly used in passive voice. It is omitted. Okay? So the general use of past tense is in simple past, past continuous and past perfect. Okay, so hope it's very, very clear to you. Now we have only one tense that's remaining, future tense. So you can just see how future tense works both in active and passive voice. You all know that what future tense is. It talks about an action that is going to happen in the near time, in the near future. So let's see the same verb eat in simple past. In simple past, the verb eat will be like will eat. Will eat. Will is used, helping verb will is used to talk about future, future time. Will means going to happen. Will eat. How it changes into passive? Will be eaten. Will be eaten. Let's see one example you may write down in your notebook. I will eat a chocolate. I will eat a chocolate. It's a simple future. I will eat a chocolate. So how it changes in passive voice? A chocolate will be eaten. So now I think it's very, very easy for you to understand how active and passive voice works based on different tenses. Yeah? I will eat a chocolate. A chocolate will be eaten by me. They will eat a mango. They will eat a mango. You may just write very fast. They will eat a mango. A mango will be eaten by the rest, you know it. They will eat a cake. They will eat a cake. How it changes into passive voice? You may just write down in the comment box very fast. They will eat a cake. So I'm not going to give how it works in passive voice. I will just check the answers that you are going to write in the comment box. Okay? They will eat a cake. You just write that same sentence, they will eat a cake, and change it into passive voice. They will eat a cake. Okay. So this is all about simple future tense. And let's come to the next part of the future. Future perfect, here it is, future perfect, we have eaten, I will have eaten a burger, I will have eaten a pizza, will have eaten, future perfect. So how it changes in passive voice? I will have eaten a pizza will have been eaten. It will change into like this, will have been eaten, will have been eaten, will have eaten, will have been eaten. Okay, so just write very fast and write one example that I would like to give you. I will have eaten a chocolate. I will have eaten a chocolate. And what is the passive voice? A chocolate will have been eaten by me. A chocolate will have been eaten by me. Okay, so this is very, very clear to you. Okay. Just write down and please write one or two examples in this simple future and future perfect in your notebook. So I request you to make more examples using all these tense forms in active and passive voice. So I think I have discussed almost all the major parts of the tense, how it works in active and passive, and these are the two tense forms in future tense is used in both, especially in passive voice. Okay? So I hope the basic understanding of how active voice is used and how passive voice is used, and why do we use active and why do we use passive. I think the general idea is very, very clear to you. Okay? So I hope today's lesson was more useful for you, and I hope you have learned many things, and I request you to write some more examples, more and more examples based on the concept that is very, very clear to you through this video today. So it was nice that you attended the whole class, and it will definitely benefit you for your reference and grammar studies. Continue learning and always take a step ahead to go and improve yourself. And I request you to improve yourself every day. Have a nice time. Thank you for learning English with me.